Welcome to the final unit of Music Theory for College Prep, Part 3. This is it. There are only 3 parts. You should be extremely proud for making it this far. In Unit 18, we will cover motives, phrases, AB form, also known as binary form, ABA form, also known as ternary form, and rondo form. A motive, according to your book, is a short, melodic, rhythmic, or harmonic element that is used repeatedly throughout a piece. It adds the catchiness to the piece. Perhaps the most well-known motive of all times lies within Beethoven's Fifth Symphony. It's very simple. In fact, it's 3 of the same notes with a major third below. Da 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 da. I know because of the motive that I just sang that you know exactly the piece I'm referring to. It repeats in note pattern and rhythm dozens of times throughout the piece. Same exact move. A phrase is a short section of music that may be either a complete or incomplete musical idea. A phrase may contain a few motives. If there's lyrics to a song, a phrase is usually, not always, the place where it makes most sense to breathe. A breath mark is just a comma above the staff. And that's usually how you determine the end of a phrase. If it is instrumental music, a phrase is the most logical breaking point. I'll give examples of each vocal and instrumental phrases with a common hymn and Haydn's Surprise Symphony. First, I'll show you by singing the song Praise to the Lord, the Almighty. I'm going to demonstrate what it means to separate music by phrases when singing. Here we go.
Praise to the Lord, the Almighty, the King of creation.
Okay, I'm almost out of breath, and I feel like I should breathe. That's usually how you know the phrase is over. It's a breaking point. Phrase 2 starts with,
"All my soul praise him, for he is the health and salvation."
Again, after salvation, I feel like it's coming to an end of the phrase, which means time to breathe. Phrase 3 starts here.
Come all you here, now to his trampled draw near.
And it even slows down around the word near. So it's characteristic of phrase endings to retardando a bit. Phrase 4.
Join me in glad hearts. Phrase one, creation. Phrase two, salvation. Phrase three, near. And phrase four, adoration.
This is an excellent example of instrumental phrases. It is the Surprise Symphony by Franz Joseph Haydn. The phrase is every two measures. So there, 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 and there. Phrase. 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 Wait for it. Songs are set up with AB, also known as binary form, current, popular, and classical both. Greensleeves is a piece said to have been written by King Henry VIII for his love, Anne Boleyn. It is set to a clear AB form. Here's A. Here is a totally different genre, still considered binary form. Well, it's actually AABAB with an intro and outro, but the song is still considered binary since the main content of it ends on the B section. The song is called Bring Me Little Water Sylvie, composed originally by Leadbelly. Moira Smiley, that woman, arranged it for women's choir. Enjoy, I love this song. This is the intro.
Bring me a little water, Sylvie.
these harmonies.
Bring it in a bucket now. Bring it in a bucket, Sylvie. Every little one say,
here comes B.
Sylvie, come running. Bucket in my hand. I will bring a little water fast as I can.
Here comes A again.
Bring me little water, Sylvie. Bring me little water.
Ternary form is similar to binary form in that it has two different parts. The difference is binary concludes on B and ternary concludes on A section. I'll narrate the video and tell where the A and B section is. A. Whether the song or piece is in ABABA, ABACA, or ABACADEACABA, if you notice a strong repetition of A, it is in rondo form. Many children's songs are in rondo form because rondos are so repetitive and repeat A so many times that the children feel a sense of comfortable familiarity with the A section, and that increases self-confidence. It's a whole thing in music therapy. Examples of these are Down by the Bay. I'm sure you all sang this at one point when you were kids.
Down by the bay,
of course, A.
Where the watermelons grow, back to my home, I dare not go. I do, my mother will say,
here comes B.
Did you ever see a cat wearing a hat down by the bay, down by the bay, where the watermelons grow. Back to my home, I dare not go, for if I do, my mother will say, did you ever see a goat rowing a boat down by the bay, down by the bay, where the watermelons grow? Back to my home, I dare not go, for if I do, my mother will say, did you ever see a frog walking a dog down by the bay, down by the bay, where the watermelons grow? Back to my home, I dare not go, for if I do, my mother will say.
Another one is by the Lori Berkner Band. It's called Let's Go Swimming. I play this song for my elementary kids all the time.
Berkner Brink, Berkner Brink, it's time to take a Lori Berkner break.
The goldfish. Lots of little fish were sleeping on a rock in the bottom of the ocean. They lifted up their heads and they shook out their tails and they said, let's go swimming, let's go swimming, let's go swimming. Yeah, let's go swimming, let's go swimming, let's go swimming in the bottom of the ocean. Then the little fish got so very, very tired that they came back to the rock. They put down their heads and they put down their tails and they took a little nap. And when they woke up, they were a little bit dirty, so they took a shower. And they washed their hair, and they washed their ears, and they washed their tummies, and they washed their very long fishy beards, and they washed their noses, and they washed their toeses, and then they said, wait a minute, we're fish,
we don't
take showers, let's go swimming, let's go swimming. Yeah, let's go swimming, let's go swimming, let's go swimming in the bottom of the ocean. Then the little fish got so very, very tired that they came back to the rock. They put down their heads and they put down their tails and they took a little nap. And when they woke up, they decided to ride their bicycles. So they rode to the left, and they rode to the right, and they rode all day, yay, and they rode all night, 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 night. They rode down the hill, and then faster still, and then they said, wait a minute, we're fish.
We don't ride bicycles.
Let's go swimming, let's go swimming. Yeah, let's go swimming, let's go swimming, let's go swimming in the bottom of the ocean.
Okay, I think you all get the picture. Now let's talk about some big cave rondos. Here is a good example of an ABACA rondo called Rondo a Capriccio by Ludwig van Beethoven. A. B. A.
feel A coming. And A. Another example is Raiders of the Lost Ark by John Williams. Well, that's it. That's all I've got for you. I've enjoyed making these screencasts for you more than I can say. I hope that you've enjoyed them too. I want to wish you the best of luck in your future musical endeavors. Who knows? Maybe one of you will be the next Mozart, or start a rock band, or become a music teacher. I hope you gained a deeper understanding of the inner workings of music and therefore love it even more. Thank you so much for taking this course. Bye!